I have boots, but I don't know, I can't wear them yet. You both already have them. Okay.
Soldier, please let me in. It's imperative I speak to someone in charge.
Ma'am, I'm sorry, but no civilians are allowed in the barracks. If you have a question, you're gonna need to send it.
Just, please. I'm Corporal Tyrant's wife. He should have been back home yesterday, but...
Yeah.
Ma'am, here. Your husband. He's one of the soldiers who returned yesterday.
Yes, I'm Corporal Tyrone Ward's wife. So he is back? Why haven't I been permitted to see him? What's wrong?
Ma'am, he's safe, but he's scared. Paranoid. Suffering severe post-traumatic stress. So what I need for you to do is tell me something. Anything that might help me convince him to listen. Before he gets himself killed.
Tell him I'm here. Tell him I'm waiting to see him. Dying to see him. Tell him about the ribbon he sent me for my hair, and that it's not just me waiting anymore. That he's... we're...
oh.
Going to have a child soon.
Oh, geez. Okay. Well then. That'll be a bombshell to drop on a guy that's already freaking out. Holy cow. Well, let's see if I can push him over the edge, I guess. That'll be entertaining. Alright.
Excuse me, soldier. I wanna...
Freeze! Not another step! That uniform ain't fooling anyone, asshole. What are you? A war spy?
Excuse me?
Look, I just got back from one hell of a mission, so if my uniform's not up to spec, you'll forgive me. But either tell your superiors I'm back with intel, or explain to them why you kept it from them. Your choice.
Ooh.
You just finished spying on the enemy? But why did you say that in the first place? Get in here before your covers blow!
Yeah, I'm gonna save before I go anywhere. Save. Yes, please.
Corporal, let's chat.
You wanna chat? Sure, why not? Not like we're at war here. Let's just have a goddamn tea party.
Okay.
Whatever you want to chat about. Oh, shit. I'm sorry, Lieutenant. I didn't see your stripes. Your uniform threw me off, sir. My mistake.
It's fine, Corporal. Stand down. Listen, Corporal, you're confused. You're scared, and I get that. Not a lot is making sense to you now, but you have to trust me. You're back in Ophir, and your wife, Maya, she's worried about you.
How the hell do you know my wife's name? Did you do something to...
Your wife's fine, Corporal. She even told me about that ribbon you sent her.
She told you about the ribbon? I don't understand. There was a goddamn war raging out there. I heard it. We were under siege. If we're in Ophir, you're telling me it's under siege?
It was. The fighting's done, though. You held the warehouse like men, so just relax and return to your barracks. Rest. Wait for your wife. She has some good news for you.
Good news? Of what?
That's kind, trust me. The kind that'll be a reason to stay safe. Stay alive.
Yes, sir.
Who?
Thank you, sir. Men. Listen up.
Nice.
Lower your arms. We're heading back to the barracks. On the double.
Good. Whew. Okay. Charisma. Yay.
Lieutenant?
Yeah, you don't like me, do you?
You know Colonel Victor?
The ASC chief? Yeah, sure. He's the head of the intelligence services. They hunt down enemy spies and rebels. But you know that already. Why are you asking? Is this a test?
No. Just interested in hearing what you think of the guy.
I don't. I don't think anything about it. Let's just leave it at that.
Okay.
What do you know about the ASC?
Why? You work for them? This is an interrogation, or... Look, All I know is what everybody else knows. They protect abundance from enemies and rebels. That the right answer? Do I earn my merit badge?
David, listen to me. I'm not...
That's what they all say.
Don't have to be an ass.
You don't like technomancers, do you?
That a surprise, Lieutenant? You go to your little private schools, cut off from the world, then just show up all clean and well-fed with your weird-ass powers, and poof, just take other officers' positions without earning them. You don't have a damn clue what war is. Never been to the front lines. Let me tell you, I have. Even fought alongside some of your so-called masters. Day in and day out, we fought together. And day in and day out, they had more respect for our damn enemies than they ever did for me or us. We ain't nothing to your great officers with their divine abilities. Fuck, they are. We show our respect to you because we know we'd probably be up shit creek in some of these wars without you. We don't have to like your kind. And I don't. It's my damn right.
True.
So yeah, no, Lieutenant. Sorry. I don't like technomancers much.
Perfect.
What do you know about Anton Rogue?
Headman of the Vori. One of my best friends. Great guy. Really fantastic. Hell, are you asking me shit like this? What I know? One of the most dangerous fucks on the planet? People say he's everywhere. Knows everything about everybody. Even us simple soldiers who never lower himself to even share a drink with. If you're looking to deal with the guy, watch your ass. Dude's a snake with friends in some very high places. Stay the hell away if you can.
You've been a soldier a long time. Tell me about the army.
Best years of my life, stuck in the worst job on the planet. Sure, it's the best army on Mars. Best trained, best equipped, most disciplined. But with guys serving for over 10 years without a single fucking promotion? How's the point? Where's the enticement to be a hero?
There is none.
Well, thanks. Another shiny fucking medal. It'll make my casket real pretty one day. No thanks. The officers are either legacies who went to the right schools or folks like you who actually went to good schools. Army doesn't care about valor in combat. They care about privilege. In my opinion.
Okay. Fair.
What's the deal with the barracks?
Fucking hellhole. Dorm smells like the bathroom and the food tastes like it was pulled from there. Training ground the size of a playground despite there being plenty of room in Ophir. That's it. Every chance I have to get the hell out of there, I take it.
What do you know about the source?
The holiest of holies, yeah? You're looking for an important building? It's there. Unless you're looking for a place to eat. You'd have to hit up the exchange for that. All you'll find around there is busy-looking people running around with serious-looking faces. Why so serious? Who the fuck knows? Just making up laws in the house of the people to ruin our lives is serious business.
You're a bitter man.
What's the deal with the slums?
Hell, man, that's my home. Grew up there. Ain't easy on the eyes, but damn if it ain't lively. Hell, most of the Ophir population lives there. All the laborers, keepers, craftsmen, and most of the ward, too. No one ever gets out of there. Ain't no time or means to make the place better, neither. When something collapses, they send the mutos to half-ass repair it. Over and over and over again.
Sounds about right.
The high-ups hate the place, but truth is, it's where the real forces of abundance and of fear are, you know? Also the home of the rogues. But I ain't gotta tell you that, do I, Lieutenant?
No.
You heard of a bar called the Curiosities?
Who hasn't? Trendy joint, I guess. Rumor is the Rebels been hanging there too, but I don't know about all that. I go in for a drink, that's all. Though I tend to get those drinks pretty fucking often. Because they're cheap and they're strong. And if you can manage to stay out of the arena or the drunken brawls, you can have a decent time there.
Yeah, tell me about it. I hate the arena.
Tell me about the front.
I haven't been back there in a while. What do you want to know? The place is a constantly shifting slaughterhouse. Sure, we'll take a piece of the Shadow Path, a mine or something, costing us a few hundred lives, only to lose it right back within a week or so. And we both take prisoners. We put ours in camps. Who the hell knows what happens to the ones they take, though? But if you're dreaming of beautiful, heroic bullshit happening all the time, you might want to look somewhere else. It's just blood and mud and rotten food. Nights of fighting, days of losing sleep, and fear. The kind that makes you know one day your body will drop. lost in a forgotten part of the world.
That sucks. Jeffrey.
Lieutenant, sorry to bug you, but I gotta talk to you about something. Look, Lieutenant, maybe it's just because I'm not used to life in the city, but...
Cut to the point, soldier.
I think we're being tailed, sir. I think someone's been watching us, but I don't know why.
All right. Any ideas how to figure out who it is?
Hell yeah. I ain't no hunter for nothing, sir. I'd say we could leave from, say, the barracks or something and head towards the exchange. But, you know, at casual, like, it's just another day. We just treat it like we're out for a walk. Then, once we know we're being followed, we lead him to a trap down a dead-end road. And pow! You got him. Or her. Whoever it is.
That's one way to go. All right. Why not? Let's try it. See what happens. What can you tell me about our captain?
I'm sorry, Lieutenant.
I want you to speak freely. It's just us.
No, of course, Lieutenant. I just... the captain's a great lady. A bit strict and not always polite with her orders, but that's nothing to bitch about. Sure, she's got her reasons, and it's for her own good. And hell, she knows a lot more than what's going on behind the scenes than we do. Hell, she came from a family of officers. She's damn good at her job, was meant for it. And I'm pretty damn proud to say she's the head of our unit. I'm just a little surprised you're asking me, Lieutenant.
What do you know about Colonel Victor?
Colonel Victor Watcher? He's, not someone I met or want to meet either. Not that I'm... I mean, I know Abundance is overrun with rebels and enemy spies, but... It's just, word is, when it comes to him, best keep your mouth shut. So I prefer to follow that advice, if you don't mind.
Noted.
What can you say about Anton Rogue?
Not all that much, I don't think. Head of the Voorhees mob, yeah? Heard he's not exactly a good man if you catch him drift. A guy no one in their right mind would want to deal with.
I did.
And, you know, being a soldier and all, I'm just an honest, hardworking guy, so I have no reason or interest to rub shoulders with him.
What do you think about technomancers?
Oh, hell. Well, you're putting me on the spot, aren't you? All right, well, you guys are strong and all that with your powers, no doubt. And honestly, you're only the second one I've ever met. First guy was at our place in Green Hope. He was a nice old guy. He taught us some terrestrial techniques, and, you know, obviously he was there for us if we had spiritual problems. But to be honest, I can't really compare him to you or any of the other ones here, of course. That said, honestly, I'm really proud to serve under you, Lieutenant. You're an example to try to live up to.
I mean, you're
just one of us regular people, and you became an officer and a technomancer. It's really incredible and inspiring.
Nice. So much different than your friend who absolutely hates me.
What do you think of the source?
Ah, an amazing place, Lieutenant. Really pretty architecture, mind-blowing buildings, all of it. Makes you proud to be part of Abundance. And you know, I'm all kinds of proud to serve here at the barracks that protect our corporation. Crazy to think the safety of the people's representatives and the Dowsers in our hands. Really cool.
You are wearing rose-colored glasses, my friend.
What do you know about the slums?
Ah, hell. Biggest dang part of Ophir and overpopulated as crap. Gotta be a miserable place to live. Too many people, too little space. And I even heard there's some rebels living in there. But how the hell can you find them? Like rusted needles in a dirty haystack. Made only more dirty by the Vori there, too. It's sad. A lot of good people gotta live among the garbage because they can't afford to get out.
You ever been to the Underworks?
Oh, yeah, sure. Place is like a crazy maze. Warehouses everywhere, tunnels leading to nowhere. Kind of crazy. I think they should really be patrolling them more often. Honestly, I swear I saw some creatures who could tear apart any poor guy working down there. Dangerous stuff, Lieutenant. And not that I'm criticizing our work down there, or I wouldn't do that.
You're from Green Hope, right? What was it like?
Ah, Lieutenant. It's a really beautiful place. You gotta see it to believe it. A lot of space, not like the city. A lot of cultivating and breeding areas. I mean, a lot of stuff that makes its way here is made there. And hell, if you like hunting, that's your place.
Good to know.
Not that it's perfect or nothing. Like, its houses aren't as nice as our Capitol buildings for sure, but it's nice there. You'd like it. Beautiful views of the desert and fields around it. Really, really nice.
You have rose-colored glasses on, sir. Alright. Back to the barracks. While I'm here, I need to go talk to you guys. You people. Talk to me.
Mr. Manser, it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. Big.
That's about the atmosphere.
Never noticed all the beggars in the neighborhood. This a new thing?
No. No. They've been here way too long, if you ask me. More and more keep piling in. They're ruining my business. Not a clue where they're coming from. All I know is they keep pouring in, broken, disabled, putting it out there for pity. Clients coming around don't like that. Me and my colleagues would pay a hefty sum to anyone who could get them out of here and move them to the slums or somewhere. You could be that someone?
Yeah. Interesting.
I can try. What else do you know about all these beggars appearing?
Not much more than you can see. They're all missing an arm, which is weird. First, I figured that they were all wounded soldiers from, you know, the front, but mostly that's because the story they were all telling. It's just a stack of lies. Obviously, time changed my opinion, because our beloved Abundance would never let our veterans and heroes flounder like that. And looking at some of them, the shape they're in, clear they were never soldiers. They're just deformed and disabled and a nasty sight to look at.
Okay.
If you chose to litter these streets, I don't have a clue.
Hello, Fiorello.
Ah, our savior is here. It's wonderful to see you again.
Mm-hmm.
You seem a bit preoccupied. Things not going well?
No, it has. Everything has gone very well because of your efforts. Let's just say that my leave of absence didn't help my business. Don't think I'm not grateful, friend. I appreciate the thought. What can I do for you?
That's Koozie. I'm going to attempt to learn more about him.
Can I ask what corporation you're from?
You can ask, but you may be disappointed by the answer. None. My parents were traveling merchants like me. The road is my home. Always has been.
Okay.
Not to take anything away from your corporation. Its technical miracles, beautiful city, and all the rest. But I don't think I could ever settle down. There is freedom in having no ties.
True.
So how does it all work? You merchants trade with each other too, or...?
Our lives would be impossible otherwise. The travel required to collect the vast array of goods we purvey would be impractical, to say the least. For instance, a fellow merchant is traveling to your hydroponic farms as we speak, and is gathering goods that he will swap with me to bring back to Alliance's territory. And there are other merchants who trade goods with me from territories even further away, and on and on and on. We would be at a loss without each other. So, we stick together. A big family, in a way.
I can't imagine everything you've seen. How far have you gone?
We can't really leave the Shadow Paths, but those ways connect nearly all the big cities on the planet. That said, my travels usually take me to Junction Complex, Alliance's main city. A place that would surprise you, I should think.
Probably.
Filled with mechanization that the corporation has rather strangely invested so heavily in. I've also been to Shadowland. Its center is far more baroque, and its slums boggle the mind with how far they stretch. But Abundance's explorers, I know, have gone much further than I. To the ends of the planet, I hear. Maybe one day you might join them on an expedition. Experience the world yourself, rather than just hearing of it secondhand.
That'd be cool.
Rumor is you merchants have a secret city hidden somewhere.
Ah, yes. The cave we open with the utterance of a magic word to protect our troves of treasures. A tale, Mr. Mansur, nothing more. We are merchants. What goods we have, we sell. To buy more goods, which we sell, and so forth and so on. There is no secret in our ways, or treasures hidden in faraway caves.
Oh, that was weird.
Who's the girl? She doesn't exactly look like a merchant.
It is a good question. I found her tied up in the warehouse that we were dumped in. The poor thing cannot even remember her own name. Figure she must have family or friends around here, though, so I keep her with me, hoping someone might recognize her. Just banking on luck, though. Maybe as an officer, you might be able to check and see if someone has reported her missing. I'm sure her family would be grateful, as I would.
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you, Officer Mansur. You are a man of endless generosity.
And there goes the sun.
Listen, maybe I can help. What's going on?
You are too kind. I am so deeply indebted to you. Anyway, yes, I am a little worried. More than a little, to be truthful. Two of my regular clients, after the kidnapping, must have assumed the worst and just left. I haven't heard from them. No one but you, I admit, cared enough to come to look for me. That said, their merchandise is here, but I have no way of telling them I am back without the risk of exposing myself. I don't mean to treat you like my errand boy. I only ask because you offered your help.
I'm an errand boy.
Anyway, if you could let them know, I could compensate you as well. One of them, I'm sure you know, the barracks quartermaster. The other one is a slums merchant.
Okay.
You know where the merchant's at?
Of course, of course. If you have a map, I could show you. Bless you, Mansur. A thousand times over, bless you for all you've done for me.
Cool. Talk to you? No? Okay.
Looky you. Glad to see you.
Hi.
I can't tell you how much your help was. It is appreciated.
Who are you?
Things might have worked themselves out in time, but who has time these days? And you sure saved me the hassle. You're a technomancer?
Who are you?
I am. Zachariah Mansur. I'm lucky. In name and in life.
Okay.
You Mansurs all stick together. Know each other real well, don't you?
Get to the point.
Know each other, maybe, but we're scattered between here and the front.
Right, right! The front. Of course, the front. So, I take it you know where I can find a... I believe his name is Master Connor?
He's still in town, away from the front, training recruits.
Why?
Lucky again. Just what I wanted to hear. Think you might be up to do me a favor?
Who are you?
Either way, I'm here. Tell me what you need.
Simple, to meet Master Connor and relay some information. With your help, of course. Without your help, well, being just a simple merchant, unwelcome outside the exchange, I suppose it'd be a bit harder. If not, you know, impossible. You know as well as I do, a common merchant can't just stroll up to the likes of a master. So, you get me in front of him, and I'll owe you one. How about that?
I'll see what I can do.
And I'll be much obliged.
Okay. Why did I walk over here again? Okay, now what am I doing? Investigate the music girl, report back to Ryan, warn the quartermaster, go to the barracks. I got a lot to do in the slums. Find the bookkeeper, investigate the bar, warn the slum merchant, investigate the girl, investigate the opposite to the regime, and secure the area. Okay. Well, persuade the beggars to leave. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. I'm gonna do that first. But we're gonna save because we got a lot to do. Save. Go talk to him.
Serum, sir. Got a drop for a poor war cripple?
No, I don't. You gotta move it along, pal.
Where you want me to go? One block over, any better for you?
Listen, I'm sorry. I am. I get it. Life's kicked you in the balls, and you're just trying to survive. And
nice.
If you were the only one begging these streets, it'd be different. But you're not. It's you and countless others making it really hard for the merchants to conduct their business. Merchants who, if I don't get you out, are more than willing to ask much less kindly. So I'm just asking you to move it somewhere else.
Keep your fake pity to yourself. You're no different than the merchants. I care about the seer. Leave me alone. Serum, sir. Got a drop for a...
No, I don't.
Where you want me to go?
Look, buddy, you look a little worse for wear, and I feel for you. Really. I'm not in the mood, so let's just move it along before I lose my patience.
What are you gonna do? Beat up a brave war vet who lost his arm on the front? I'm just trying to raise enough serum to...
Look, buddy, you look a little worse for wear.
Yeah. What are you gonna do?
I don't have a choice.
I didn't try to reason with you.
I don't want to attack the guy.
The hell's wrong with you? What, do you want to get beat? Should've left when you had the chance.
I ain't got no chance or choice, mister. They already took my arm. Said if I left my spot, they'd take my life.
What are you talking about?
All I wanted to do was escape abundance. Have a chance at a real life. The kind I imagine every day. A life I believed the smuggler was gonna give me before he trapped me. Before he threatened to turn me over to the ASC for treason if I didn't steal for him. So I did. I may be poor, but I ain't no thief, sir. So after a few days, I told him I was through.
Aww.
He thanked me for my honesty. Shook my hand. And mid-shake. Cut off my arm and threw me onto the streets. Beg for serum or die, he said. You feel big singling me out now, sir?
Nope. I feel like an asshole, actually.
Hey, hey, mister. You got some serum, mister?
No, I don't. And you folks gotta clear out. Let's go.
We gotta... You gonna protect us if we do?
No, but I'm sure you'll be fine.
Yeah, you think? We leave, the smuggler will kill us.
I've heard the stories. Promised to help you escape, then made you steal, then cut off your arm and thanks.
That's right. But more than just mine, sir. Many more.
Know where to find this guy?
Yes, sir. At the station, sir. But you ain't gonna get near him dressed like that, sir. He'll see you coming blocks away. Look a little more poor, dirtier, and you might have yourself a chance.
I hear you. Thanks.
Equip your team with beggar's rags. Okay, so that means I have to buy beggar's rags because I don't have any.
Hello?
Hello. Looking for some medicine?
You know what? I'm gonna bet I can't buy him.
Hey there, Fiorello.
Ah, the one, the old...
Pilot's goggles. Beggar's rags. I don't really want to have to buy them, but... How much do I even have? Oh, that hurts. That hurts a lot. Doctor's pants, worker's pants, worker's boots. You have recipes? You have recipes! Okay, sell that. Do you seriously have another quest for me, sir?
What kind of merch are we talking about?
Boxes of equipment for your quartermaster. From Alliance.
From Alliance? Our rival corporation?
Just one of the many, like Aurora. But Alliance, being at the cutting edge of military research, clearly has goods your quartermaster is interested in.
And what's the merchant buying?
Mostly exotic ammunition. The kind used for hunting. Different prey require different rounds, from my understanding. The more exotic the prey.
I hear you. Thanks. Where'd you find the girl?
We were actually thrown together. When they brought us to that wretched hellhole warehouse, there she was. Tied up. Unconscious. Tortured. Through and through. Whatever she did to get that sort of treatment, couldn't have been as bad as all that. So when you arrived to free us, I, in turn, freed her. I always tried to pay a good deed for her. Mm-hmm. She would have died had I left her behind. Since then, I've asked around the exchange, but nobody seems to know her any more than she knows herself. Perhaps she comes from the slums, somehow betrayed the Vori, stole from them? Who knows? But whatever it was, the punishment was brutal. But maybe, as you go around the city, maybe you'll find a way to bring her name back to her.
I don't know what you want me to do, so I'm not gonna keep talking. Oh, it's just telling me that that's okay. I need to go over here. So I need to make a left, and a left. Okay. Left, left, and left. Oh man. This game is very interesting. There's a lot of depth to it. The game's so pretty. This game reminds me a lot of that movie with Christian Bale in it. I can't think of the name. Drop a Plan with Jeffrey. No. Not ready yet. Hold on. Madam?
You already back, Lieutenant Zachariah?
Talking to, or was it this guy? Oh, I'm stupid. It was this guy.
Hi.
Quartermaster.
Lieutenant, how can I help you?
I'm dumb.
Hey, Ryan. Merchant just delivered this for you. Said he's got more merch you may be interested in, too.
Oh, good. Bastard finally showed up. Damn foreigners. Good thing they're better at making deals than they are at minding their clocks or calendars.
I solved your problem, Quartermaster.
Is that so? And how'd it go?
No lives lost. But if we don't find an antidote to the drug, I doubt those men will see a day outside a cell for the rest of their lives.
Thanks, Lieutenant. We owe you one. A friend of mine working on the test actually sent us a sample, and we should be able to make an antidote with it. Eventually, I hope.
Give me the sample. I know someone who could probably find the cure quickly.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Nice.
If he succeeds, he will help us out a lot. Here, take this.
Nice. Yeah, I gotta go to Scott. Alright. Do I still need... Whoa. Slow down there. I need to be in here for some... What is this? Van. Find the Black Dahlia gang. Because that makes sense. Save game. Yes.
Ready to try your plan out?
Ha! Yeah, absolutely,
I love
Lieutenant.
Jeffrey, even though he's really
right.
Naive.
Just out on a stroll,
stroll right?
Yeah, just a stroll. He won't suspect anything. Let's head out this way.
Follow Jeffrey's plan to draw the spy in.
We should probably go right now.
Don't tell me we're following that idiot.
We can head down this alley and over towards the archives.
This is just sort of funny to me.
We'll pass security, and there's a chance he might get suspicious, but I think we'll be fine.
Did you hear? We finally got the psychopath who took a hostage.
Oh? How?
A technomancer officer. The whole thing was completely nuts. That lunatic only did it so they'd wipe his gambling debts. Can you believe it?
Pretty easy to believe when you know who takes care of those debts. Vori don't mess around when you owe them serum, no matter how small.
Don't look now, but we gained a tail, Lieutenant. Let's just keep heading this way a bit further, I think, and I'll prove I was right. Sir.
Lead him into a dead end.
Yeah, there we go. He's following us. Just gotta keep him with us until we get to the dead end street and pass the checkpoint. We'll corner him there. Dead end's right there. We just gotta get him in there, and we'll have him trapped. We finally know who our spy is, Lieutenant.
Who the hell are you? Why are you following us?
You got nowhere to run. You're surrounded.
God.
Fuck.
May find something that'll help explain why he's tailing us.
What the hell is this? Looks like a notebook. And I'm willing to bet it's Alan Manser behind all this shit. Looks like the little rat reported me to the ASC.
What? Really? Why would another Manser tell on you? And for what? You're a great lieutenant, sir. You haven't done anything wrong.
Yeah, well, let's just say Alan's not exactly a fan. This time, a little shit's gone too far. He's gonna give me an explanation.
Oh, boy.
What could that technomancer have said to put the ASC's crosshairs on you? You seem like a pretty nice guy.
Hey, watch your mouth! Don't ever hint at the lieutenant doing anything wrong. Whatever they say he did, it's just political bullshit. Of course.
I'm sure this kind of thing doesn't happen to you often. Hypothetically, what would happen if I reported you? You think you'd get sacked?
That's not funny.
Oh,
reporting
geez.
Someone is a serious claim.
Both of you shut up.
Oh, jeez. So I've got one cheerleader, one over-enthusiastic cheerleader, and one who hates me. Got it. I am oddly okay with that. They're a dysfunctional family, that's okay, that's cool. I'm going the wrong direction. No I'm not. And I'm just taking the scenic way to get there, I guess. That's fine. Alan, you're gonna have a lot of explaining to do, my friend. About why you're trying to report me. When I've literally had this job like 2 days. Can I open the door, please?
Master Connor isn't in the chapel. The Great Master will know where he is.
Zachariah, a pleasure as always. What may I do for you?
Missions?
I'm looking for Master Connor. Any idea where I can find him?
He headed down to the Underworks, needed to get some supplies from our warehouses. If you're going there, take the elevator near the barracks. Opens up close to the warehouses and will save you some time. It's a real maze down there.
Thank you.
Thanks for the tip.
afternoon, it looks like. Oh, hey, can I open this? Oh, I can. Ooh, I've got an achievement called Raider.
Hello, Ellen.
Zachariah Rogue. They haven't sent you to die at war yet? A damn disappointment.
A little bird handed me some notes about a spy authored by a little rat. The rat should leave me alone and cut the shit out immediately.
I'm not sure I like your tone, Rogue. I have more important things to do than waste my time with the likes of you.
I should have known you wouldn't own up to your own lies. That would take courage, which you're lacking.
Ouch.
A rogue will never live up to the reputation of a real Mancer, and it's high time someone showed you. Oh, I've been waiting for this.
Oh! Hi.
Are fighting with students.
I'm sorry, Master.
He started it. What did you want me to do?
As for you, Ellen, your constant provocations will one day find you an early grave. Don't fancy me a fool, for the fool is you.
Nice.
Try something like that again, Ellen. Please, try it again when no one's around to bail your sorry ass out.
Reputation with Jeffrey. Yay! Jeffrey likes me. Guess that's a good thing. Level up. Stealth. No, stop. What is this? Lock picking. Develop this talent. Ooh, I want that one. Spy's tablet. Overload. Ooh. I have that. Go this way. I don't even know what the main quest of this game is anymore. I'm just running around doing like everything else. It's crazy. Alright. I need to. No, you are the one with the beggar's robes. That's right. You're the beggar. Nothing else on this level, and everything else somewhere else. Alright. I go to the Underworks, and I got a lot to do in the slums, so let's go to the Underworks, which is some other direction. Okay. Thank you. Underworks. I will talk to Connor, tell him that the merchant is around, and then we'll go to the slums and do, you know, 900 things in the slums, including trying that arena fight again. Okay. Let's go find Connor. Oh, hey, can I... Oh. That's not good. Ow. How about you, guard.
Dear Zachariah, a pleasure as always to see you, and my gratitude for your help. Now, please, stop calling me master. You're one of us now. What brings you here?
I met a merchant fresh off the exchange who'd like to meet you.
Strange. Some delivery I'm not expecting, or something else?
He only said he had information to give. Didn't say what, but I thought maybe there was a chance he learned something about some relics during his travels.
Relics are more the great master's field of expertise than mine. I like to stick to molding our young recruits, but come, let us see what this is all about.
Yeah, let's get the serum first, though. So he doesn't really know what's going on. I certainly have no idea what's going on, but I guess we're gonna go find out now. I need to save before I go over there, though. I do not trust it. At all. Seriously, run faster than him? Of course I do. Why would I not run faster than the NPC? I seriously have to follow him. Dude, where did you go? What are you doing? Discreetly listen in on their conversation.
Is it really you? Andrew?
His son.
Can it really be?
It's his son.
I hate to disappoint Master Connor, but I don't die easy. And I have a little too much pride to just let myself be tossed out with the trash. We got some explaining to do.
It's gonna be his son, I bet.
We did not toss you out with the trash. We just did not know how to help you. Your talents were uncontrollable. So we sent you away, hoping you would forget. Move on.
Hoping I'd forget? When? As 10 years of my life wasted away at the hands of a merchant? I want my goddamn life back, asshole.
I'm so sorry. I don't know how I could make it up to you.
I don't know. But you can be damn sure I'll think of something. Get out.
Andrew, I cannot tell you how remarkable to see you. Simply remarkable. Pardon me, Zachariah. You cannot know how unexpected this was. Thank you. I must now return to the source.
Who'd have fucking thought it? A technomancer spying on other technomancers. Crazy shit right there. From where I've stood, it looks like you were all stuck together tight as hell. Shows what I know.
Yeah, it does.
Keep your mouth shut.
I'm just shocked, Lieutenant, that's all. Shocked and, just shocked.
Oh, boy. Oh, hey, wait, what was I supposed to do? I wasn't paying attention. Quest, what was I doing? Complete mission assigned. Yeah, I know that. Break the opposition, investigate the opposition of the regiment. Yeah, I didn't do that. Haven't done that either. Secondary quests. Here we go. Okay, yeah, do the Mexican Boxer. Arena yet? Find them later. Ask Scott for an antidote. Gotta go down there. Routine with Beggar's Rags. Haven't done that. The Black Dahlia gang. Warn the Slab Merchant. Mark of the Past. Investigate someone called Andrew. How do I do that? Map. Oh. Oh boy. Okay. Barracks, I guess. Get that taken care of, then I'll go talk to Alan.
You already back, Lieutenant Zachariah?
Nope.
What does the name Andrew mean to you?
The long version of the name Andy? How about a last name? No? All right. Give me a second. I have a vague recollection of an Andrew linked to an accident at the Technomancer's school years back. Is that what this is about? Some affair at the school? If it is, listen closely, Lieutenant. You're an officer now, not a school teacher. And I can't afford to have your attention divided. So get your head around that and out of the schoolyard. We clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Of course, Captain. Crystal clear.
Oh, does it mean I can't go talk to Alan now? Damn. Alright. So, I need to go to the slums and do, like, everything else. Alright, that's the underworks. I want the slums, like, way over there. Perfect. Let's go back in here. Let's go this way. It's faster. Faster, faster. I should have talked to Alan first. Oh well. It is what it is, I guess. Ooh, it's nighttime.